Hey, what's up guys? This is Anthony from Anthony's Customs, and for this review we are looking at the Joyride Grunt. This is the original design for the Grunts, and it is my favorite. And of course it is the orange Grunt, and that is also my favorite. I don't know if he came with these two weapons in particular. These are just ones that I happen to have with him, so I think they might be his. But we have a needler, nicely done, and a plasma pistol. Joyride did a pretty good job on all of the weapons, and there are a couple different versions of the weapons for most of them, so you may if you buy these guys loose you may end up with different than what I just showed you. I'm not sure, and I didn't check to see which ones he technically came with, because I think they had a couple issues of some guys too. But somebody asked me to review my Grunt, and this is what I have. I never bought one new, so I'm not 100% certain. Okay, he stands to the top of his head 4.5 inches tall, and a little bit taller since the backpack sticks up a little higher, the methane tank. It feels like it can come off like the Halo 3 Grunt from McFarlane. It cannot. It is not meant to come off. If you take it off, you will break it, so don't do that. This guy is covered with nicely sculpted details. That's very much appreciated. I love good sculpt work, and this guy has a lot of it. He has decent paint work. Joyride kind of had a bad tendency of making battle damage and scratch marks looking like paint streaks, which is really what we see here on the shoulder pad. I don't know if I'm able to show you that very well. This light's kind of reflecting, and it's silver paint, so it doesn't look quite like it's showing up, but you can see on the chest how it looks. It's not great, but it's not horrible. There is lots of paintwork going on throughout the body to emphasize the sculpt, so that's nice. The bone details that are sticking out, very well done. Overall, it's a very nice looking figure. It's not great, but definitely for the price point when it came out, and even for what you can get it for nowadays, it's still a pretty solid figure. As far as articulation goes, the head, it can swivel. It can look up and down a little bit, but that's probably just because the way the joint's made, so I wouldn't count on that. Just the swivel, really. For the arm, or for the shoulder, we have a hinge for up and down, and a swivel to go around. We have a sort of bicep swivel right up there, and then a wrist swivel, just a cut joint. Same thing on this side, slightly different hand sculpt, but same articulation. And then for the torso, we just have a swivel. Well, it does rock just like the head does, but it doesn't really hold the position, so it's really just the swivel. This is a separate piece. This whole chest harness and backpack is a separate piece, so that might move around a little bit, but it's not meant to come off or anything, so don't bother trying. And then that's it. There's no articulation in the legs, even though they're sculpted and painted well. That's it. So he's going to stand pretty flat. Pretty much however you pose him, you won't have too much trouble thanks to the non-articulated legs. But you can get him in some decent poses with the arm articulation as it is, so that's pretty good. I'm pretty happy about that. I do wish they made his eyes stand out a little bit more, but the original Grunt did have the black beady eyes, so that's okay by me, and it's definitely a figure I recommend if you're a Halo fan. So there it is, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more figure reviews, custom figures, and other good stuff, and in the meantime, keep collecting.